Hi everybody, it's Vahid Razavi. Just want to highlight a few things. First of all, we're releasing 1.3 million tons of contaminated nuclear wastewater in Fukushima into the Pacific Ocean. That's where we get our sushi from. That's where we get our seafood from. So now they're all going to be neon colored and glowing in the dark thanks to the nuclear waste that's being released. In Zaporizhzhia, the Russians have taken the Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant as a trophy, and they're using it to as a hostage against the Ukrainians in their fight for liberation. In North Korea, they're starving their population, yet they have nuclear technology and nuclear bombs and missiles pointed at the U.S. and Japan and the rest of the Korean Peninsula. In India and Pakistan, they both have tons of nuclear weapons pointed at each other. Israel, of course, has another couple hundred nuclear bombs and does not subjugate itself to IAEA inspections. Iranians want to get their hands on nuclear reactors. Same with the Saudis and the rest of the Gulf states. And they're working hard in terms of getting, you know, access to nuclear technology. Do you trust these government leaders? Do you trust the governments that I just mentioned with having access to nuclear bombs? Was it the last administration that had the football, or the Chinese or the Koreans? So do you believe that the North Koreans should have the right to have nuclear technology? Do you think Iran should have it? After all the waste that's been generated after Chernobyl, after Zaporizhzhia, after Fukushima, do you think that this technology should continue to prevail? I don't think so, and a lot of our speakers don't. Our speakers are Francesca Fiorentini, comedian, journalist from the Bituation Room, Will Durst, the funny comedian from the Bay Area that's been doing political comedy for a long time, and hosts the Will and Will Show with Willie Brown and Will Durst, the old mayor of San Francisco. Our other comedians are Chloe McGovern, Annette Mullaney, she speaks Arabic, and me and Dave from the Bay Area. So we're excited to have them. In addition, speakers from RootsAction, Normon Solomon, Common Dreams, Brett Wilkins for Church of Fellowship of All People, Dr. Dorsey Blake, and Veterans for Peace will be speaking at this event. With music from Mike Ruffo, it should be a lot of fun, it should be entertaining, also educational. That's been my goal the whole time, is to produce content with the help of great talent and company that can educate the public on important matters. And there's nothing more important than our future when it comes to nuclear technology, nuclear waste, and nuclear weapons. And we need to remember Hiroshima Day so we don't repeat it again. So thank you. Hope to see you on August 6th. Tickets are on EventBrite, Hiroshima Day, and please make it. Thank you.